we close the closed session. Do I hear a second? And we did receive a report on RSNM status. That's what we did. Okay. So next thing is commissioners' comments.
I just got one, Madam Chair, and that's on the LME, and maybe Craig can bring us up to date a little bit with what's going on with that, because we did have a concerned citizen here last week, and was very concerned last meeting. And I don't know if you can brief us on that just a little bit.
We actually had a meeting today with our attorney, Castle Manager, and his attorney, OPC, and their attorney, and our LME, Deborah Welch, and their attorney, Mike Taylor. And what we're trying to do is find a common ground on the letter of intent for merger. And we missed the deadline before the original letter from OPC to the our LME was not approved. Now we've gone back, and hopefully we're finding common ground where the letter can be approved. And I believe our LME has a board meeting tomorrow night. Hopefully that letter can be approved, and then that will be sent to OPC for hopefully their approval, and we can start moving forward with the merger process after that.
So is there seem to be more consensus between both boards now, or?
We're getting there.
Okay.
We're working on it.
Okay.
We're getting there.
Okay. Anything else? Okay, we'll go to announcements, and I do have a couple. First of all, I want to say congratulations to everybody that won their elective seats. Sheriff Johnson, Mr. Sutton, and Mr. Lashley. Is anybody else in here?
Nope.
Okay. And I also want to thank Ms. Vaughn for her 4 years representing the board, and we appreciate what you've done. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. In fact, let's give her a hand.
Yeah. And the next thing I want to do, I got this in the mail this week from the Education Lottery, and I didn't know what was up. I thought they was going to send me some money, but they didn't. But
your part.
Did you get it? Yeah. Oh, yeah. Anyway, this is a distribution of the fiscal year of 2010 funds by county. And to date, and I guess this is just for 2010, it says that our total to date, no, this is all the years. Our total to date is $19,750,516 that has come in to the Alamance County school system since they started the lottery. The total for fiscal year 10 total is $6,070,412. That's just for fiscal year 10. So that's a lot of money coming into our school system that people don't realize how much money this lottery is bringing
and
in.
Goes to and construction costs mostly.
Yes. So anyway, I just wanted everybody to know that, because it looks like I'm
the
only one. We
hope that's where it's going.
Yeah. It looks like I'm the only one that got this, but it is a little pamphlet that they did send through the mail to me from the Education Lottery.
It does the auditing of books.
They have a separate audit.
It came in with this one.
Did they ever change the formula? Yeah, first when this thing first started, our tax rate was so low that a county comparable to us with the same money flow going back from the lottery, if their tax rate was higher, remember that formula?
But we would get
less, and they would. Did they change that formula?
They changed it back. There was a different formula they used for this year's that was supposedly they were keeping more.
Right.
but we actually broke even on it. So it's a confusing formula. They played around with, you know, they've held funds back for 2 quarters, and then they released it. And
see, in essence, what was going on was if our tax rate had been, say, 8 cents higher, property tax,
you get more money.
We've got more money back because they had the formula
geared
to
where
it made it look like we were doing more for the schools, you see, and they would give us.
John Locke Foundation now says they want to do away with the lottery. Did you hear about that? Yeah, I don't quite understand that, to be honest with you.
Do away with the lottery?
Yeah, that's John Locke Foundation. It was in Greensboro's paper Sunday.
Any more announcements from anybody on the board? If not, we are adjourned.
Thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur at 7 p.m. on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioners' website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the County Commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel beginning at 10 o'clock p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching commissioner meetings online. For technical questions about this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of commissioner meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says Alamance County Commissioners to visit the commissioners' website, where you can learn about our commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting.